Hola y buenos días. Damas y caballeros, es un placer estar de vuelta en la Ciudad de México y un privilegio ser invitado a formar parte de este evento. Gracias a Arnaud y su equipo. He visitado México muchas veces y siempre he disfrutado de mi estancia aquí. Me encantaría decir que mi español es fluido, sin embargo, la verdad es que no lo es. Y el resto de mi presentación será en inglés, así que por favor, tengan paciencia conmigo. I thought it might be nice to start with a short video, after which I'll tell you a little bit more about the team and some of our fan engagement strategy. Enjoy.
Huge respect to these guys. It's a fantastic sport.
Watch.
Give it everything now. Give it everything.
I love you guys.
Come on, retire. Come on, retire. It's stupid.
Safety car. Box.
Woohoo! What a race.
We can have it. We can win this race.
Having been to the Autodromo earlier this year, I have no doubt that if I'm invited back next year and we have a similar promo video, there'll be many, many shots of the Mexican Grand Prix in there. And I just want to say on behalf of Force India, a big thank you to Horacio for his part in bringing Formula One back to this beautiful country. We cannot wait to come here in November. With regard to Force India, I'm sure all of you are aware of Sergio Checo Perez. You might not be as familiar with the team. So I just want to give you a bit of a potted history as to who we are, which hopefully in turn will become relevant. Back in the early, or the late 1980s rather, a flamboyant Irish entrepreneur by the name of Eddie Jordan formed Jordan F1 and raced in Formula One between 1991 and 2005. It was an independent team funded predominantly through sponsorship that he brokered, and he had the likes of Michael Schumacher and Damon Hill racing for him, both of whom went on to become world champions, multiple world champions in the case of Mr. Schumacher. Fast forward to 2008, and another flamboyant entrepreneur, this time a billionaire, by the name of Dr. Vijay Mallya, decided to buy a Formula One team. Vijay made his money in, I guess, the Indian equivalent of Corona, Kingfisher beer, and his ambition was to have the first Indian-owned team on the grid and to challenge with the big boys. He's achieved both of those. If we fast forward to today, we are a very different team to that we were in 2008. We look at ourselves as being a challenger brand. We do want to mix it with the big boys, but we have to recognize where we sit in the hierarchy of Formula One. We are privately funded, and we have a budget that's roughly a third of the manufacturers or the works teams, the Mercedes, the Ferraris, if you will. So we have an operating budget of somewhere in the region of $100 million a year compared to $300 million of the big boys. And I always refer to Formula One as an iceberg sport because most people see Sergio Perez and Nico Hülkenberg out on the grid and not assume completely, but don't see much past those two drivers. We're a small team and we have nearly 400 people working back at Silverstone in the heart of Motorsports Valley to make them go as fast as they possibly can on the circuit. Mercedes, current world champions, are 5 minutes down the road from where we are. They have 1,100 people working there. So it's not a level playing field on the track or off the track. And from a commercial perspective, that means that we have to work very hard to keep up with them. Our COO, his raison d'etre is to all of our sponsors, your investment makes us go faster. And that's why he has sent me over here today to continue discussions with a number of Mexican brands about partnering with the team. I mentioned that we have to work harder. We also have to work smarter. And we pride ourselves on having some of the values written up there. We're fiercely competitive on the track. We don't take ourselves too seriously off the track. So the work hard, play hard ethos is our mantra. If any of you become our guests at any of the Grand Prix in the future, I'm pretty sure we can guarantee you a fantastic experience. We're seen to be the fun team on the grid. I think the success of Force India has come from our desire to push the boundaries. We work for a commercial rights holder, ultimately report into Formula One management, who control the sport quite stringently. But where we can, we like to break boundaries and think outside the box. That's appealed to a lot of the sponsors that we're working with at the moment, and ultimately helped us to continue to challenge with the big boys. 2014 was our most successful season to date, with a record points haul, and right up until the last race in Abu Dhabi, we were competing with the mighty McLaren for fifth place. We hope to continue that development, and as Vijay says up there, develop into a global brand. Already, we are seen as a credible alternative to the big boys, and if I'm honest, a cheaper alternative. Damon Hill, twice last year, was quoted as saying that he saw us as being the best pound for pound team on the grid. And Bernie Eccleston, the Formula One supremo, is of the firm belief that one day we will win a Grand Prix. Let's hope that's this November. So if we look at the traditional form of consumption in terms of the fan experience, Formula One has historically been sold very much on eyeballs, and that continues to be the case. It's a very powerful and compelling proposition. It's a truly global sport. It touches five continents. There are 19 races this year, and over a billion eyeballs will see brands associated with the sport in one way or another. However, we do have challenges. As I mentioned, we have a strict commercial rights holder. We're very limited to what we can do once we get inside the circuit. There have been criticisms that the sport is deemed to be elitist and it's not engaging with the youth. And from that, of course, we get pressures from sponsors who have multiple opportunities to work with other sports, whether they be mainstream sports or the upcoming extreme sports. So we have to create a point of difference. And our view is to try and deliver value from social media. And it was really one of these conferences that I was at not so long ago. I listened to the marketing director of Barcelona. He's got a tough job. And he was talking about the way they were innovating and having to innovate, even though they're Barcelona. And he came out with a couple of statistics that really amazed me. 97% of Barcelona fans live outside of Spain. 97%. And they did an experiment whereby they sent out an image of a goal celebration from Luis Suarez. I'm not sure if it was in the El Clasico, but it was a fantastically emotional celebration. And they tracked it, and it was viewed 61 million times on social media. And their question was, you know, the value to Qatar Airways, which was their shirt sponsor, was huge from that, but it goes largely unrecognized in pricing sponsorship and coming to an agreement with a brand. And it just struck me that an awful lot of our fan base is overseas. So how can we engage with that audience, both in a social remit and on a local level? Quite clearly, Mexico is very important to us strategically. Since Checo arrived in the team, along with America Movil in 2014, we've been very fortunate, very blessed to have the support of a number of major Mexican partners. NEC, sponsors here today, we're delighted to say, have joined us this year, Interprotección, Consorcio, and many more, hopefully, to come. We started talking to Mexican brands before the Grand Prix was announced. We took a strategic gamble, if you will, and also looked at it on the basis that 2015 was a very relevant year politically, because it's the year of the UK and Mexico, and the year of Mexico and the UK. And we'd already started discussions with the government or the ambassador in the UK, and various government departments here in Mexico. But we were conscious that we needed to build the awareness of the team in Mexico and increase our fan base alongside supporting our driver, Checo Perez. And we wanted to be innovative in the way that we did that. So how do we do it? Every year, each team unveils a new car. Some changes are more drastic than others. Over the last couple of years, you may or may not be aware, but there's been significant changes to the engines and the design of Formula One cars, and ours is no different. And our latest iteration was VJ08, which we were very proud of. It was a new livery, a new design, and a new chassis. And what we wanted to try and think is, how can we incorporate social media into launching this event? And we therefore tapped into some local expertise in the guise of Claro Sports. This all came about, this whole campaign was done in 6 weeks, so I have to say hats off to all of those guys in Mexico who helped us do this. Because our brief, and the brief from Carlos Slim Domit, who supported us, was we want maximum impact in minimal time. We decided to focus on the motorsport fan base here in Mexico via their Scuderia Telmex, and felt that the best way of doing it to maximize the reach and engagement levels on social media was to do it in a two-phased format. So we launched via Facebook, and we used an easy promo tool to help us manage it. The first phase was just to put out 10 very generic questions, not difficult ones, about the drivers and the teams. Get people talking, get people having a little bit of competition on social media platforms. Those that answered the questions correctly then went into a second phase, where they actually had to justify why they should be part of this launch. And I should add at this point that the premise of the whole competition was to enable members of the public to be part of the unveiling of the car. Historically, and certainly over the last few years, what's tended to happen was that you would have the drivers at Jerez in Spain at the testing stand next to a car that has a blanket over it, and they would unveil it on the count of three, click, 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 it appears on the front cover of a magazine, and that's it done. We recognized the way that we could be a little bit, or we thought we recognized the way of being innovative and combining the two. What happened was that those who got through to the second phase had to rely on friends on social media to vote for them to be part of this. And that in itself generated over 4 million impacts on social media and 4 lucky winners. So these guys, and look at their ages, between 23 and 29. So we've ticked one box of engaging with the youth. Could have been some more girls there, but we can't win them all. So these guys came along to the Sumaya Museum, where the event was hosted, and were involved in absolutely everything up to the unveiling of the car. We had many people, prominent political figures, business leaders, attend the event, and this is what it looked like. Thank you. The event itself evolved more from a launch of a new car into really the beginning of the countdown to the Mexican Grand Prix. We created a strategic alliance over the winter with CIE and OCESA, and the following day, the car and the drivers were down at the Autodromo for a media day and an official unveiling of the track, which we were delighted and still are delighted to be a part of. We're very proud of our links to Mexico, and we see a very strong future ahead of us. But the question is, did it all work? We believe it did. We had 10 international broadcasters fund themselves to come over and film the event. The social media organic reach was fantastic, 36 million comments on Facebook, 22 million retweets. A record number of visitors went to the Sumaya Museum to see the car. The guys at Infinitum and Claro Sports created some really clever stuff with augmented reality. If you download the RA Infinitum app and go to the NEC stand today, you'll be able to have your picture taken with Sergio Perez. A version of Sergio Perez, I should say. And there was a record number of visitors, as I mentioned. But ultimately, you know, those brands that were involved in it, the team, the government, benefited from over $17 million in equivalent media value. And we'd like to think we benefited by winning a few more fans in Mexico. Gracias por su tiempo y atención. Espero que les haya parecido interesante. Si desean hablar más acerca de cómo trabaja con Force India, podría ser un gran beneficio para ustedes o cualquiera de sus clientes. Estoy disponible y encantado de hacerlo. Fuerza India, o debería decir Fuerza México, no puede esperar a la carrera y vamos a hacer todo lo posible porque sea un gran espectáculo. Muchas gracias y vamos, Checo.